they're jealous of you, or they just bully you for fun. Now, who's the new students here? Yeah, so I'm just going to bully you all because you seem strange and different. No. There are three types of bullying. The first type is verbal bullying. It hurts people by words. And as the example in the first part of my speech, that's a type of verbal bullying. And sometimes people also use phrases like this. You're fat, so I think you should die, freak. No, we shouldn't do that. Sometimes people even say phrases that make people want to cry because they are too scared. Like, I'm going to spill out all of your secrets if you don't do that. No, that is a horrible, absolutely horrible way to bully. And the second type of bullying is social bullying. That's when you hurt someone's reputation or relationship. And we embarrass people in public, or we tell others not to play with them. That's a very common way to bully at school. And you may think that it's not a real big deal, but actually it does. It is. And it is because nobody can be lonely, right? Can you be lonely? Do you want to be lonely? Do you want to be isolated? Of course not. And I have my own personal story, and it hurts me a lot to think about it again. So about 4 years ago, I was in a popular group of girls. And one day they found out that I had head lice. You know, the thing that bites you on the head and then you just want to scratch your head all day? Yeah, that's the head lice. And then when I got over the head lice, they still stayed away from me. And they told others not to play with me. And I was lonely for a long time. I had no friends to play with, absolutely no one. And I lived a life like that for 3 months. And it was awful, but luckily, new students came to the school and I had friends again. Now, the third type is physical bullying. It is the worst one because it hurts both your emotions and your reputation, and it also hurts your body. It's like a combination of verbal bullying, social bullying, and physical bullying. They hurt your body because you hit them, you slap them, you pull their hair. And that hurts. Of course it does. And once I watched a video, and it showed a girl being slapped and was bullied by others. They pulled her hair out, they kicked her, they punched her. She felt hurt. She was sad. That hurts her emotions. And she was actually hurt physically. That hurts her body. And she feels embarrassed. That hurts her reputation. And if you find that scene awful and you want to stop it, then you have to understand your role in bullying. You could be the big bad wolf. He bullies Little Red Riding Hood. Little Red Riding Hood is the victim. Or you could be Little Bad Fox. He encourages the bullying, but he doesn't join in. Or maybe you could be the squirrels. The squirrels are the outsiders. And they don't join in, but they also don't defend the victim. And my favorite, the hunter. He stops the bullying and he kills the big bad wolf. But actually, in real life, don't kill the bully, right? So you should all be the hunters. And in conclusion, I want to ask you some questions. Do we tolerate bullying behaviors?
No!
Do we want bullies?
No!
And I want you to say this chant with me. Bullies are fools. No fools in school. Bullies are fools.
No fools in school.
Bullies are fools.